We've checked the arbor. We've got our 1,000ths runout, which passes the specifications for this particular brake lathe. So now we're going to check the actual cones and adapters that are used to mount the rotor on that arbor. So here's the problem. These get used for a lot more than just holding the rotor on. Sometimes we use them to press seals in with. Sometimes they get dropped, whatever. So think about this. If this surface right here is not smooth, if it's got a couple little dimples in it from somebody using a hammer or something, when you slide it on the arbor and it goes up against the face, it'll actually sit on an angle. Well, that'll throw your whole rotor alignment off, and that in turn then, you'll be machining run out into that rotor, which is what we're trying to avoid. So one of the ways I can test this really quickly is just take flat surface, take the actual cone itself, the adapter, run it on some, and look and see if I got full contact. In this case, I'm not having a full contact on this pad right here. Seems to be doing really good on these 1, 2, 3, 4, but this one's not really hitting good. So either I can continue to sand until I actually can get full contact all the way around, which is what I'm going to do, or I can actually mount this on the brake lathe and machine these cones down. Everybody thinks that can't be done. We do it all the time here in the training center. But the other idea I want to also do, get across to you here, is this side. This side is the side that's going to be up against the machine, flat surface. I'll do the same thing with this. I'll just take it on the sandpaper. That seems to have really good contact all the way around. So I'm pretty sure this is going to be okay here. But I can mount this on the brake. Now I can't really check it with the dial indicator. That'll be rough to do with these pads right this here. But what I can do is mount it on, put a known good rotor on, and check it that way also. I can check all my cones that way actually, and make sure they're all in good shape, and try not to use them for anything other than the brake lathe itself.